Hey everyone, happy holidays, and it's extra happy for me this year because I've come all the way back home for the holidays. I'm here in my hometown of Manchester by the sea, Massachusetts, small little town right next to Gloucester, Mass. A lot of people know of Gloucester. I'm here with my mom, the one and only Sophie Brown, the best mom in town, and it's so nice to be home for the holidays.
It's wonderful to have you here for the holidays with your family.
Of course, we would have rather brought it out to RPV next time. But yeah. It's special to be here because, you know, I growing up in a Greek family with lots of special traditions at every holiday, especially. There's different ways we love to cook. And there's a way we do Greek turkey and Greek stuffing at the holidays. And that's what we're going to do here, right here in my mom's little kitchen. Kitchen of Love, yes. And the recipe that we're going to share with everyone is many generations.
Yes, absolutely. It's been handed down from grandmother to grandmother to daughter, and here we are. And it's strictly nut and meat stuffing. So delicious, you can eat it as a meal.
So let's just start off, Mom, by telling them we're going to show them the basic ingredients that go into Greek stuffing. Starters, it has meat. So how much, we're going to make enough stuffing that would fill a 26-pound bird.
Yes, this will fill a 26-pound bird amply and maybe even have some left over. But we're going to have at least 2.5 pounds of hamburger.
2.5 pounds of hamburger.
And we're going to have a couple of cups of celery and the same of onion. And we're going to saute it in some bacon dripping so it really gets a nice flavor.
All right, so you always have to cook up about a pound of bacon first.
Right.
That's to start everything going. And then they'll put the celery and the onion in that, saute that up
right.
With the meat.
Right, to braise it. And then after that, of course, we add some parsley. We can salt and pepper to your liking. We're going to add breadcrumbs. We're going to add ground walnuts and chestnuts. And we're going to add raisins as our final touch.
It's actually a bonus touch to the raisins. Being Greek, we have a metaxa, a Greek brandy. And we took about 1/4 cup to add to the 2 cups of raisins, soaking them. Gives them a nice little rich flavor when we mix that in. But that's an optional.
Right.
Some people might not want
really
that.
Really tasty.
And right now what my mom and I are doing, though, one of the stuffing, Mom, takes probably an hour easy to put together.
Absolutely.
It's a good hour prep, but it's worth every minute of it. And what we're doing now is we took 2 pounds of chestnuts. My mom scored them, you know, cut a nice X on each one, that takes time. Threw them in a pan, covered them with water. And how long did you boil them?
20 minutes after they come to a boil. And then you want to clean them while they're still warm because it's easier. Hopefully, we're scooping it out of the shell.
That's what we're doing right now. We're scooping them.
And hopefully the peel is not coming with it. That's what you really don't want to have attached to them.
It comes right out after you've boiled them up. So one of the tricks, my mother, being Greek, we cook with a lot of cinnamon stick and cinnamon. And so, as you'll see, when we're going to actually get the stuffing together and stuff the bird, the magical trick is, and you can do this with any kind of stuffing, I do it when I make regular stuffing, is to put a cinnamon stick right in the cavity of the bird, right in the middle of the stuffing, and it just gives it this really nice hue. And so as the holidays are approaching, it's like a busy time, so it's kind of nice to be able to just sit and do something like this, don't you think?
Absolutely. This is our little pause. It's refreshing.
A little pause, and we're going to take a quick break. We're going to come back, and we're going to be ready to mix up everything together to make the best Greek stuffing you're going to ever taste. So stay tuned.
It's a promise.
All right. My mother and I are back making Greek stuffing and turkey, and we finally chopped up 2 pounds of chestnuts. There you go. The labor of love, though, it was worth it because this is going to make this so delicious, this Greek stuffing. So my mom has now put her sauteed hamburger, celery, and onions, and she put also a couple teaspoons of salt and a teaspoon of pepper on that as well. So now I'm going to start having the fun part. I'm going to dump the ingredients in. So this is the 2 pounds of chopped chestnuts, nice and thick, and then to that more nuts, two cups of walnuts. And then next we have 4 cups of breadcrumbs. These are just, we've store-bought. You can, you know, venture into making your own. Does that help?
You will add warm water to this to get it to the right consistency that you want.
And then, you know, we're gonna add the raisins in. Here we have 2 cups of raisins I mentioned earlier. What we do is we soak it, the raisins, in 1/4 cup of metaxa. And metaxa is a Greek, is it a scotch or whiskey?
It's a brandy.
It's a Greek specialty liquor. And also very tasty at the holiday time in eggnog. That's also nice. So I'm going to put the Metoxa soaked raisins in, and just for a little Greek good luck, I'll throw a little splash in there.
Yes, definitely.
And
oh my goodness.
So here we go. This is all mixed up. The next move we're going to do is we're going to show you, we're going to put this stuffing in the turkey.
You spoon this into the cavity of the bird. And you want to make sure that you don't stuff it too tightly, because it is going to, it's going to puff up a little bit once it starts cooking in the bird and the juices start falling in there. But
now we're cooking about an 18-pound bird, and as we said, the quantities of the stuffing mix we made will fill about a 26-pound bird. So, as my mother said, you can just, you know, we can just put it in a casserole dish, the extra stuffing, which we'll do unless we eat it before the holiday. And there you go. And so you have plenty of stuffing. So that's good, Mom.
Do you want to put any more in that?
I think we're good. And then what we're going to do is we're going to take Italian bread. And so what we do is we just sort of, we kind of just put it, make it into a little, to cover it up, put a couple pieces, and it will keep the stuffing from coming out during the cooking. You're going to do the pepper, and I can help you move it along, get some salt going. This is a joint effort. Cinnamon stick is key to my mother's Greek turkey.
Just stuff it in the middle.
Pop that right in there.
And all the way in as far as
you don't
as
eat the
go.
Cinnamon stick, but when the, oh, the stuff comes
what
out.
What it does for the flavor of the bird is unbelievable.
So I've got that stuffing in there with a cinnamon stick all ready to go. Onions, carrots, and celery, your basics all around. And then, again,
and then water.
She was talking about pickling spices right here.
Yeah. Couple,
and this is, again, I think the secret to my mother's bird. So I'll give you a tablespoon.
Well,
and you sprinkle them all over the vegetables. And you can do another tablespoon. And do you actually put the pickling spices on top of the bird?
No, I don't put it on top of the bird.
So there you go. This is Sophia Brown's Greek roast turkey. We're going to pop it in the oven at 400 degrees covered right now. And we'll check it out. You seal it and you lower the temperature to 350, right?
Right.
And we'll be, so we're going to start it, we're going to wrap it in foil now, pop it in, and we'll return. And when we come back, we're going to have the turkey coming out of the oven, and we're going to check out just how delicious this is.
Pull your hip out. Beautiful. As they say in Greece, poli oreo. Very beautiful, Mitetta. Which is mother in Greek, Mitetta.
Happy cooking.
See you in about 4 hours,
See
baby.
You in about 4 hours when it's done.
All right, Mom, it's finally happened. 4 hours in the oven, and our Greek turkey with stuffing is finished. Beautiful bird. I call this a no-fuss turkey. What I love about my mother is when she cooks, it's delicious but simple. A lot of people spend all kinds of time basting. You basically cook this turkey at 400 to start.
Right.
For about a half an hour. And then when it was covered, lowered it. She never bastes it. And it's beautiful. Lots of juices. And of course, she does add water to her bird. Now let's check out the stuffing.
Okay.
The Greek stuffing.
Okay.
Here we go. First scoop, looks good, smells great. I smell that cinnamon stick, which is the secret to Greek stuffing. And we're gonna continue to scoop those beautiful raisins and the chestnuts, everything together. Now I'm gonna try it. Can I try it?
Yes, absolutely.
There we go.
Absolutely.
Marbling.
Good?
Good,
it's a winner.
And Greek,
it's
poli oreo.
It's a winner.
Okay, now my mom and I are gonna go carve the turkey up. In the meantime, we want to wish everyone in Rancho Palos Verdes on the Palos Verdes Peninsula the most happy holiday season from here on the East Coast, the West Coast. We love you all, and enjoy it, and enjoy the time with family and friends, because that's what it's all about, right?
That's right.
It's all
family,
about
family, friends,
about
getting
the
together,
and
dining together, mm-hmm. conversing with one another.
And even though I'm here on the East Coast with family, I know you'd rather be in California, right? Rancho Palos Verdes?
Definitely.
She loves being in Rancho Palos Verdes.
I love those sunsets.
She loves being on Portuguese Beach Club.
I'm ready.
Shopping at the Interpretive Center.
Exactly.
All those fun things. You love it, right, Mom?
I love it.
Okay, well, for now, we're here on the holiday season, back on the East Coast, but enjoy my Greek family tradition, and happy holidays to everybody.
And Kali Orixi.
Kali Orixi.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell swing and jingle bell ring.